The first official leaderboard has been released. We can finally see our standings in the Versus series, and we're going to be taking a look at it today and seeing how much further we can progress here in this episode of Minecraft Prisons. Let's get into it. Yes, hello everybody, welcome back into a brand new episode of Minecraft Dopey Prison. Today, of course, we're back here on Akuma MC, the best and most overpowered prison server. Now, if you guys do wish to join me, then the IP should be on screen right now. It is Bedrock and Java compatible, so I would love to see as many of you guys online as possible. But guys, today, like I say, the leaderboard is officially made and it has been released to us so that we can view our standings in the Versus series. And I have had a little sneak peek, I'm not gonna lie, and I think you guys are gonna like the results. So let's get straight in with today's episode. We've still got our full hour to use, so I'm gonna get straight in and we're gonna start off with the Versus claim, and that should, I believe, take our balance of coupons, yes, up to $60, which is a huge part of a huge piece of progression, really. Like, that is going to be huge in the coming episodes. We're going to be able to spend a little bit of that here in the next three episodes. Now, before we get into anything further, I want to announce the giveaway for today, which is in fact going to be $20 Bycraft credit. Okay, guys, so $20 Bycraft credit for the giveaway for today. So if you want to be in with a chance of winning that, then all you guys need to do is go ahead and make sure you have left a like on this video. You need to go ahead and comment your username down in the comment section. Make sure you have subscribed to the channel, and then you need to enter my Discord and press the enter button on the giveaways channel. It is that simple. As long as you've done all of those steps, then you will in fact be entered into the giveaway for this video. So let's take a look at the leaderboard for today and see exactly where we stand. If we do slash versus top, it's going to show me right here. As you can see, our account name this season is the top one who does this, and we are in first. We are literally in first. The only person close to me remotely is K, and K, I think, is going to end up being our number one rival for this season. Now, the goal of today's episode is to essentially do all of the steps that we can to pull out this lead as much as possible in this next hour. So that means we're going to be utilizing all of the methods that we know to prestige the fastest, to rank up the fastest, and we're literally going to exhaust everything to make sure that we can get out ahead of everybody else in this episode. Now, first and foremost, what I need to do is make sure that both of these pets are fully upgraded. Now, the fact that we only have a rare rank up pet doesn't sit well with me, so I'm going to open a couple of pet eggs. Wow, that was a good win, a mythical token pet. I'm going to open a couple of pet eggs that we have sitting around and try and get ourselves a better one, because if I could get the top tier, then we would actually be good to go, and I would never really have to, I would be able to upgrade it and not have to worry about whether we are wasting our time or wasting our money or anything like that. So, I don't know actually if we even have anything other. I think that's all that we have right now. Do we have any V kits available? We should have OP kits, I think. Easter claimable in 23 hours. So no, we can't claim that. Let's have a look, see if we have our OP kits right now. We don't have those either. Okay, so we don't really have anything to get extra pets. So I think for now, we are just going to do what I wanted to do. So prestige pet, let's go ahead into slash pets. I'm going to put this in here. I'm going to upgrade this so that it gives me a bigger boost. It's going to cost me a good amount of crystals to get this upgraded, but that's okay. Not too really worried on the crystals right now. We'll spend it all actually on this pet. There we go. We now have a 72% boost on our prestige. So actually, it's probably just as well that we couldn't do the rank up pet as well today. And to be honest with you, prestige does affect the score a lot more. So let's go into a little bit of how the score is worked out. So as you can see, it says that we have 8,500 points right now. So the way that that is determined is actually quite simple. So if you take my rank, which is 658, and you times it by my prestiges, which is 13, you're going to get that number. Now, it might actually be a little bit off now because I think it only updates every like hour or whatever, but it is essentially around that number. Now, what will happen is when we do actually hit the rebirth levels of rank, then every rebirth is an extra 100 points. So for example, when we hit rebirth 1, that'll be 1,000 ranks. So that'll be 1,000 base times by however many prestiges we have. And then if we hit, if we were to then hit rebirth 2, it'll be 1,100 times however many prestiges we have. So essentially, we want to work on getting our prestiges up there as much as possible. But rank is also very, very key to us because obviously prestiges, I believe max prestige is 100. I don't think you can go any further than that. I'm pretty sure it is capped out, which I don't know if we'll hit this season. I really don't think we will hit this season. So I think actually prestiging is probably where our focus should be lying. So it's almost a very, very good thing that we've upgraded that prestige pet, because I've got a feeling that once we're allowed to use armor, which I think we're coming out to a point where armor would be useful. So I think maybe next weekend, we might go ahead and release armor to be able to be used. So what I might do in a couple episodes leading up to that is not use it, but we will open up our armor boxes and try and form ourselves a prestige armor set. I don't know if it's realistic to hit 100 prestiges in the season or not. I think with the mixture of drills and stuff, which reminds me, I need to activate my miner. There we go, because he will actually give me drills. If you guys didn't know that, then now you know. He can, in fact, give us drills through the enchant which he has, which is called Scavenger, I think it is. Yeah, Scavenger. And we actually have everything maxed out on him right now, so he's doing the most that he possibly can. He also helps with rank ups as well. So actually, that miner is a very, very useful tool that we have. But yes, what I'm saying is I think that we might, between all of the different methods that we have of prestiging, we might get to the cap. I really don't know if we will or not, but if we do, then we're going to be a little bit screwed if we've only been focusing on prestiging and have no kind of core or no tools to rank up as well. But I think, honestly, we're probably safe to focus on prestiging for now, because, I mean, even if we do max that out, we'll be way ahead of everyone else. They won't be anywhere near to maxing it out, so we'll be in a good position, to say the least. So I think we are focusing heavily on prestiges. We're kind of leaving ranks to be what ranks will be. Obviously, ranks are affected by pets and whatever, but they're not really going to be affected too much by the different enchants and stuff that we have right now. Because the percentage is so low, like, nuke just about helps when it goes off. Like, well, actually, no, it does help a good amount. It's like 20% or so. So nuke helps, but there aren't really many other enchants that will help on the level that nuke is. So I think, yes, we're going to form ourselves a prestige armor set for once armor is actually released. We've got ourselves the pet, which is mythical tier, top tier, and I believe we can only upgrade that a couple more levels. In fact, we should be able to afford one right now. Let's chuck this in here, see if we can get a level or two. One, two. Oh, it's maxed. Perfect. We have that one maxed now. That is good news. Our prestige pet is officially giving us the best boost it can, which is a 75% boost, which is actually a lot of a boost. Like, that's really good. If we pair that with max armor, if we're able to get max armor, I don't think we can get max armor. Well, maybe, because it costs gems to upgrade, and we actually do get a fair amount of gems. I think so, in which case, our long term, we need to focus on getting gems, because that's going to be how we upgrade our armor. Honestly, we are getting a solid plan in place here. So we need gems to upgrade the armor. We need the armor to give the extra prestige boost. And if we can get to prestige 100, that'll be my rank times 100, which would be put us massively in first place. Also, you may be wondering, why am I not spending my coupon balance? We actually have $60 saved up right now, and I have some intel that hopefully there should be a new crate coming tomorrow. I don't know whether that's fully confirmed. I've heard rumors, so hopefully that's kind of why I'm saving it. I think that there is going to be a new crate coming, and obviously when the new crate comes, it gets buffed based on the current season, you know, where we are in the season. Ooh, that's my pickaxe thing going off, I believe. Yes, it is. Don't really know if that's affected or not, but yes, either way, the crates get buffed based on the season and how far into it we are. Obviously, we'll be more into it than we are now, so the crates should be better than they currently are. So that's why I'm waiting for that, just in case you guys were wondering. That is the reason behind that. We also have a bunch of mine rewards. Ooh, a pet egg. That could actually be clutch. Hang on a second. What if we end up getting the exact pet we need? We don't, but you know what? It was a good thought. It was a really good thought. I had the idea there. Are these are loot crates. Okay, we don't really need to open loot crates. Robot generators, again, don't really need to open them. What are we going to get from this? Oh, not great. Not great, if we're being honest. But yes, today is very much a grind episode, as a lot of these episodes have been. So I think I'm going to get my head down, get to some mining. We're about to prestige as well, so I'll see you guys once we do that. Alrighty, should be prestige time. There we go, which means we'll actually go ahead and be able to spend ourselves a skill point, I think, unless it already upped itself to 2 points now per level. No, it's still one, which actually is going to give me a quiver boost, which is perfect, because quiver gives me tokens. Tokens, of course, is exactly what we need right now. Because we are working on profit actively, I guess I should also work on zoo. It gives me tokens and crystals. Don't really know which one's the best out of all these enchants, so I'm just kind of evening it out a little bit. I obviously want to make more tokens right now, because tokens would help us. It's the one thing we are really short of. We also have crystals to spend, which we can't really afford anything right now, so I'm going to leave that. We also have gems to spend. I think I'm going to continue. I guess we should go with mana, because that mana last episode was very, very effective. Black hole is cool, but I don't think it really does anything. I'm reluctant to put any more levels into that. So let's just try and max out Whisperer, because we know for a fact that Whisperer is one of the most overpowered enchants that we could possibly have right now. Let's put it all into that. So yeah, let me get my head back down to mining. I don't know what's going to be up next. I don't know what will come around, but I got a feeling we got some good things right around the corner about to happen. So yeah. Oh, actually, before we do that, one thing I do want to do is actually open a whole bunch of the pickaxe things, which we need to do, the pickaxe skin boxes, because we actually have a lot of these that we could open right now, so we may as well do it. I believe we can open pretty much all of these. There's a couple which we can't. Prestige, yeah, we can do that one, can't do that one. Yeah, we can open most of these, and honestly, if we can get the best pickaxe skin going out of these, then we'll be good to go. I'm actually just going to close straight out of these so that we don't waste too much mining time here. Getting a lot of mine splitters, a little bit of a lumberjack there. Mine splitter again, Reaper, don't really want that one, we don't really have any of that. Night Fury, that's the one we want. Lumberjack again. See what we'll get this time. Mine splitter. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to apply these all onto my pickaxe so that we know exactly what we've got and what we're working with. So let me go ahead and click all these on so that I'm not like spamming up freaking spaces in my PVs and stuff like that with these tokens, because we may as well figure out what we've got based on, you know, what's actually on our pickaxe. So I'm going to do that quickly. And it looks like we did actually unlock mine splitter as well. So that's pretty cool thing to note, that we do actually physically have that enchant unlocked now. So yeah, nice little thing to note. I think that's all of the shards that we have available to us right now. I don't think we have any more, so we should be good to go there. Perfect. So we've got all of that applied. I'm going to use my drills quickly as well, get some prestige up, may as well, while we've got our pet active. There's no harm and using them, and in fact they should help me out a little bit. It's not going to give me huge amounts of my prestige, but it'll give me a little bit. May as well use all that we've got, because you know there's no need in saving them. You just kind of need to use them as you get them. I guess I could also open up all of my mythical keys, which should give me a couple more drills. The only thing I don't like about opening mythical keys now is they freaking don't all open at once, so you just lose that kind of an easy opening method. But that's okay. What I'm actually going to do is not do that, because that was kind of a waste of a drill. So I'm going to trash all this other stuff that's not going to give me anything useful. Reset the mine, chuck my other drills down. There we go. This should be a nice little progression, actually. We should be able to get prestige probably 16 today, I think. Let's have a look. How long have we actually played for today? Because honestly, yeah, 15 minutes only. Wow, that's really, really good. We're actually in a really, really good position here. So yeah, I'm not going to complain about how today is going at all. I'm just starting to realize how effective these prestiges are actually going to be. The fact that we have prestiged a couple of times today is actually massive, in the fact that it's going to literally add the extra, like, what is that, 1200 to our score, which is absolutely huge. Now I don't think it's a live command. Oh wait, maybe it is. Maybe it does actually live update. Hang on, we'll be able to tell very easily. 338. No, okay, never mind. I don't think it live updates, but I think it's on less of a delay than the global leaderboards, which is good, because it means that we can see that we're easily ahead right now. I think my aim would be to surpass 10,000 today, which should be a fairly easy one. Like, realistically, we're about to get another prestige. That's going to add another. Yeah, that's an easy goal. That is literally completed as soon as we hit this prestige right here, which we're literally about to do. I'm going to drop that drill in. Might as well get that extra little bit and slash prestige. Get it ready, because that drill should hit it for me. There we go. Boom. Done. Easy. Simple as that. Wow. This is, we literally have now taken out a little bit of a lead. So this is where skill points start to cost 2. That's fine. We'll leave that. I don't know if you guys saw that, but right at the end of the tree there, if we can get our prestiges all the way up, we get a huge gem finder boost, which reminds me, we should probably start focusing on getting that fully maxed. Let's have this easy 500 levels right there of gem finder. I think, yeah, that is probably one of my next just big focuses in getting that done, because we're going to need the gems. Gem enchants do cost a lot, and we've still got a good couple coming up that we're definitely going to want to max out. So yeah, I got a feeling that that should really be our next target. Okay, so it does somewhat live update. As you can see on the versus leaderboard, we have now surpassed 10,000 score, I guess we could call it, which means that we're basically 10 times ahead of the last place, which is perfect. Means we're doing our job right, and it means that we're over, or we will be, I think, at the end of this episode, over 2,000 away from the person behind us. So that is huge, huge progress. We will actually be more away from the person behind us than the person in last has in total, which is, you know, Flurp, you got to do a little bit of catching up here, bud. I think you're a little bit behind. If I can get more in one episode, then you might be doing something wrong. I'm thinking for right now, we may as well put the token, or not tokens, what is it? Crystals into this pet, because although we have a small level cap on it, like, I think it's still going to make a decent difference. Yeah, 24. 24 is mad. 24% of a rank up is mad. So we'll take that. 24% rank up boost. That is way better than what we were getting before. And to be honest with you, crystals, like, we only have one enchant left on crystals. So I don't think getting crystals for us really is a big issue. I think that we could easily complete the crystal enchants very, very soon. So I'm happy to use them where they're going to benefit me elsewhere right now, like on that pet. I've seen the Zeus enchant go off a couple of times now, and I don't really think it's doing a huge amount. Like, I can see my tokens definitely going up when it goes off, so it is a noticeable amount, but I don't think it's like huge, you know. I really can't tell, but it is going going up. So we'll take the fact that it's going up as a good thing, but I still do want to focus heavily on just here. Look, we can actually max this thing out. Well, pretty much max that one out right now. Get gem merchant maxed out. And then we, if we get gem finder maxed out very, very soon, then we're going to be in a very, very good place. All right, there we go. We have gem merchant absolutely maxed out right now. So we just need to focus on gem finder. And then we're going to be in the best place in regard to that enchant. We do have some gems to spend. So let's go ahead. I think, again, just chucking it straight into Whisper is our best bet. I think it makes the Whisper last longer and it also increases the proc chance. So it's kind of a win-win. You can't really lose when you go ahead and do that. So yeah, honestly, Whisperer, one of the best enchants out there. I know I say it a lot, but I just really do agree with the statement. Alrighty, another 2Q tokens to spend for us. It goes just going straight into Gem Finder. Like, it's the enchant which we really just have to get done now, I think. We're on 3K, though, so we're not really... It's not bad progress at all. We're really getting there with it. We've actually... I would like to say, like, probably almost doubled it today, which is a huge amount of progress for us. And also, our prestige is about to go up. We are bordering on the line of prestige 16 now, which is huge because obviously that's going to add another whole 600 score to our lead that we have right now. So if we actually have a look, we are going to be clear. I would like to say, yeah, we'll be over 2K levels clear of K, and in fact, we'll be closer to 11K than anything else, and maybe even by the end of the episode, we won't be quite at 11K, I don't think, but we'll be getting there. We'll definitely be getting there. All right, prestige, let's do that. Let's also spend our prestige skill token that we got for a gem boost. We'll take that. There we go. Honestly, we're getting there now. This is really coming together quite well. Versus top, there we go. We are virtually, we're borderline 11K right now, which is just crazy to think about. And we're also getting there on Whisperer. Like, that's coming together. We'll probably have that maxed in like a day or two, which is huge. Like, we're getting so many things maxed out now that I think it is just genuinely a token race now. I think tokens is really all we could like be getting that would be benefiting us. So if we can figure out any other enchants that will be adding to tokens, then we'll absolutely take them at this point. But guys, I am in fact going to end the episode here just because what I want to do is have a little bit of a surprise for the start of next episode to see how much we have to spend and all the upgrades that we get to do. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to finish my mining off, but I'm going to end the video here, guys. So if you haven't enjoyed it, then make sure you do go ahead and smash that like button for me. It really does help the videos. And it also, I don't know, it's a good feeling, you know, with you guys all hit the like button, so I really do appreciate it. Of course, make sure you subscribe to the channel as well. If you're not subscribed, then the chances are you won't even get to see the next video, so make sure you do hit the subscribe button. It really helps YouTube know that you want to see these videos. And yeah, good luck to the rest of the people in the verses, because I've pulled out a very, very, well, I'd like to say a very, very strong lead today. I'm not tooting my own horn, but I kind of am. But yes, guys, that is going to be it from me today. Hopefully you have enjoyed. I'm going to continue mining, and I'll see you all in the next episode here of OP Prisons on Akuma MC.